I'm Tori, and today I'm going to be reviewing The Bird and the Sword by Amy Harmon. I listened to the audiobook narrated by Trina Nishimura. So this is a beautiful fantasy novel that feels like it has a lot of kind of fairy tale elements in it. It's not really a fairy tale retelling, but there are just lots of little bits and pieces that make it feel like a fairy tale. So in this world, there are four different kinds of magic that some members of the population have. There are spinners who can change one thing into another, like spinning straw into gold. There are healers who can cure the sick. There are changers who can turn into different kinds of animals, and there are tellers who can see the future or cause things to happen in the present. And in this society, all of these gifted people are very feared, and the monarchy works very hard to make sure that all gifted people are completely eradicated. And so if anyone has a gift, they keep it very hidden because it is an offense punishable by death. So our main character is a girl who is a teller, and her mother was too. And when she was about 5 years old, she was playing with her toys, and she made all these little dolls called poppets, and she gave them words and made them dance and fly and do all these cute, charming little things. And one got away from her and flew out the window. Just as the king was coming by, her mother took the blame for it and was executed right in front of her. And with her dying words, her mother used her gift to take away Lark's voice so that she would be able to stay alive and not be executed. And so she's lived all her life, she's in her early 20s now, and she's lived all her life without the ability to speak. Now, at first I thought this was kind of a young adult novel, you know, the fairly predictable fantasy young adult novel where, you know, the girl goes and has her powers and then she uses them for great deeds and then she'll fall in love by the end of the book. And I was really impressed with this story. It seems much more like one for older readers. It doesn't follow that particular plot arc. She does encounter the young king of the land fairly early on, and she is taken to live in the palace with him. And it's very interesting to watch their relationship and to watch Lark kind of learn to use her powers and maybe find her voice or find a voice and a way to communicate her wishes to others and to be a strong person in this world. And I love it that she is a very independent, strong woman, but she doesn't do that by yelling and stamping and swinging swords around. She is very calm, and she feels so silent and so helpless, but kind of by the end of the novel, she learns that this very quiet, subtle strength that she has is more useful than the ability to scream. So I thought this book was absolutely beautiful. It is part of a series, but it feels like a standalone novel, and I think that the next book will feel more like a sequel. This book is a complete story arc in itself. You don't need the second book to make it into a full story. So I would highly recommend you go read that, then come back if you want to hear some of my opinions. So I loved this story. I loved watching Lark kind of find herself. I loved watching her relationship with the king. I thought it was fairly historically accurate that they were married and then discovered that they loved each other. That seems like something that would have happened a lot in medieval Europe. You know, marriages were arranged and you had to kind of learn how to live with each other. And I thought that was a very interesting storyline. It was so interesting to watch, you know, they both really cared about each other, but they were terrified of admitting it, and that was so interesting. I also thought the atmosphere of fear was really interesting in this book, and I love the idea that the people who persecute the hardest are the ones who have the most to hide, and that once people came out as gifted, it turns out that most of the people in power did have gifts, and that it's so much better to teach people how to control their gifts and to make laws that punish them for their actions and not their abilities. I thought the prose in this book were very beautiful, and the whole narration and being inside Lark's head was just this gorgeous, fragile story that seemed beautiful and sad and wonderful, and I loved it so much. This book was absolutely breathtaking. It felt like a fairy tale, and the whole story was just so gorgeous, and I loved watching Lark quietly moving through this world and finding her inner strength and just becoming a good queen who could serve her people well and keep the land safe. The relationship between Lark and her mother was beautiful. Even though her mother was only alive for the first chapter of the book, you could just feel that bond so strongly. And I just loved watching all of the characters. This book had very strong family relationships. It was so interesting to see all the relationships between parents and children, and just all the different ways that family can interact and support each other and make each other strong or tear each other down. And I enjoyed watching this relationship and comparing Lark's relationship with her mother and her father, and with her servant, who was really like a father to her. I also loved all this book had to say about the power of words. You know, Lark is a teller. That is the most powerful gift, and she can do so many things with it. And of course, in this world, words have magical powers. But in our world, words have quite a few powers too, and just the way she perceived the world and the way she felt when people talked to her, you could feel that, and you could feel that all words have power, even the ones that aren't magical. This was such a breathtaking, achingly beautiful story, and I enjoyed it so much.